What's going on, YouTube fam? It's your boy Tony Two Times, and we back with another episode of The Baltimore Way, man. I appreciate the love and support, like always. Y'all know what I need y'all to do. Like, comment, share the video if you're feeling the content. Check out the links in the description. Grab you a t-shirt or something. But tonight, we're going to get right into it. So tonight, we're going to talk about Norb Brown. I'm going to call him M. Brown because his name hard to pronounce. On the outside looking in, M. Brown seemed like a regular civilian living in Middle River, Maryland, Baltimore County. He would go pick up his kids on a daily basis, just chilling, right? Wrong. M. Brown, who was legally blind, by the way, was an alleged kingpin. He was the head of an organization that transported, manufactured, and sold Ready between New York, Harford County, and Middle River, Maryland. Allegedly, M. Brown would get others to drive him around while handling business and getting money. M. Brown was the plug. Him and his brother set up shop all over Baltimore and Harford County. They would drive to New York and get weight, bring it back to the county. They would cop powder and turn it into Ready for more profit. Him and his brother would split the weight. M. Brown in Baltimore County and his brother in Harford County. But hustling and standing out around blue-collar people in the county can be dangerous. And soon the police started watching M. Brown. He was the focus of a 7-week investigation by the task force. The force focused on him and his brother as main suspects. Investigators used electric surveillance of M. Brown and his people via text messages and cell phone calls. Visual surveillance of the squad's movements between Edgewood, Maryland, and Middle River. Even sending an undercover in to infiltrate and cop from him. The squad started to trust the undercover and allegedly sold him more than 100 grams. The two brothers and their homegirl was planning to take a trip to New York to see the plug. But things would go left on one Saturday morning. M. Brown and his brother and homegirl were in the car traveling to New York to re-up, but task force was tracking the group electronically to and from New York. The group was pulled over on I-95, but turns out M. Brown's brother was slick. He got out of New York and stayed up top. So he left the group, so they only had him and his homegirl in custody. Harford County Police charged the group with distribution, conspiracy, possession with intent. When police got M. Brown in custody, they were surprised to realize he was legally blind and getting a whole disability check. He was real mild-mannered and well-spoken. Police would soon tie other members to the case. M. Brown was facing more than 40 years in prison. In this game, they say focus on the money. M. Brown didn't have sight, but he had the gift of gab. At the end of the day, it was the blind leading the blind. But sometimes that's the Baltimore way. Man, it's crazy. So Norb was blind, you see what I'm saying, legally. Like, he couldn't see. He couldn't drive, nothing like that. Now, this case interesting because it happened in Baltimore County. Like, what a lot of people don't understand, I tell people all the time, it's a lot of money in the counties. Everywhere I've been at, every state I've been to, the suburbs is where the big dudes live at. And they bring the weight to the city and drop it off. But when you think about it, it's really not cool because you got the dude living a good life, laid up somewhere in a mansion, but then you got dudes in the hood fighting over crumbs. You see what I'm saying? So that's why dudes in the hood be beefing and stuff like that, thinking they gonna get to the level of the big man, but it's a cycle. You'll never get to that level. Only way you'll get to that level if you get plugged in directly with the people that got it or with the big man himself. But a lot of times it be people like M. Brown. It's people that you never expect. People that live a real low, kind of low profile kind of life. You see him, he probably got a regular little car. He got his kids with him. You ain't really paying him no attention. You see what I'm saying? But whole time, he got a basement full of that thing. So it's crazy, but I'm not sure how much time he got. I know his brother was more plugged in Harford County. So they was bold because me, man, super familiar with Middle River. I bought one of my cars out Middle River, you feel me? And me being familiar with Harford County because my daughter actually was born out there, and I used to be out there all the time. Like, when I used to go out there and see dudes hustling and stuff like that, I'm like, y'all crazy, because it just ain't look right. Like, I'm saying, people get money everywhere, but you could just tell that it was a lot of people watching them. But I guess you could say that about anywhere, but in certain environments, you could kind of get away with it a little more. Like in a city, you used to pulling up, saying 100 dudes everywhere. In certain parts of the county, like Essex, Rosedale, you see a lot of people outside. But when you start going towards Harford County and stuff like that, it get real, you know what I mean? It just get different. But M. Brown ain't care. Like, them taking their trips to New York, that's how they was getting the money. Because you got to think, I-95, for y'all that's not familiar, that's like the hub. That go between Maryland, I think Pennsylvania, if I ain't mistaken, and New York. So they catch a lot of people on I-95. I-95 then gave out a lot of time because people go grab what they grabbing. You got to go through all them tolls, so you got to stop a lot of times before you get to where you going. And by that time, the police already on you. Or if you got grass or something like that, you done stop at a toll booth. One of the toll people done called the police because they smell it. Now you going to prison. So yeah, man, I mean, M. Brown's situation a little different from everybody else because, like I say, for one, he was legally blind. But for two, he a little older. Like, I feel like older dudes move different. You see how he moved in his little group, him, his brother, his homegirl. Like, they weren't too deep. They had other little people on the payroll, but at the end of the day, they moved kind of like, if you ain't paying no mind, they'll look like a regular family in a grocery store or out in public. But they ain't commit no violence. That's the crazy thing about it. I always tell y'all, violence bring the police. But in certain environments, like I say, when you're around working class people, people that's nosy, that watch you all day, they see you ain't going to work, you feel me? You got the old people sitting on the porch just observing, and they call the police. You see what I'm saying? So that's how I feel like this happened. I feel like he was just getting his check. The neighbors wanted to know what was going on with him, and they was too comfortable. Like, one thing about it, if you in a game that long, you don't never let nobody introduce nobody to you talking about this my man, or let somebody walk up to you talking about they need 100 grams. Like, no, it don't work like that. So if you is gonna be out there, man, be smart. But you know, regular is cool, man. I'm gonna keep telling y'all that. Go do something else, you feel me? Go be a producer, go start your own business, start a clothing line. Speaking of that, man, y'all be sure to check the merch out. I'm gonna leave a link in the description. I appreciate the love and support. This the M. Brown story. This another episode of The Baltimore Way. Leave your comments below. Let me know what you want to see next. Be sure to like, comment, share. Love, fam.